But Peter, how do we get to Neverland?
Fly, of course.
Fly?
It's easy. You think of a wonderful thought.
Any happy little thoughts?
Uh-huh.
Like toys at Christmas, sleigh bells, snow?
Yep. Watch me now. Here I go. It's easier than pie.
He can fly.
He can fly.
He flew.
Now you try.
I'll think of a mermaid lagoon. Underneath a magic moon. I'll think I'm in a pirate's cave.
I'll think I'll be an engine brain.
Now everybody try. One, two, three.
We can fly, we can fly, we can fly!
Hey guys, so that was my crappy little attempt at video editing or whatever. I don't really have much experience with that, but I just thought that I'd add this at the end here. Just, I mean, I know obviously you saw what it looked like, but just to comment on, you know, the last couple things going on with the project. You see Peter? He's my favorite. Yeah, I was initially going to make these guys out of balsa wood, which is lighter and stuff, if you've worked with it before. And so my sticks here stayed straighter. But because the balsa wood was splitting across the front and it looked really bad, I used this, like, I don't know, plywood. And now they go... They kind of, you know, lean forward. And so that kind of inhibits the way that they behave when you turn the mechanism. But I mean, you'll see that they'll go, and like Peter or John or whatever his name is, you know, he goes all the way around there. But I mean, that was just something that came up at the last minute, and just with my other classes and stuff, I just did not have time to, like, do it again. Lighter wood, so this is what happened. And then also because of time and like gravity, I don't have to do that here. I was originally using wood glue to attach these guys, and like I did it for Michael. Did you know that's the youngest brother's name? Anyway, I attached that with glue, and then I put just like that little piece of tape on it here, and then tape on wet glue equals tape stuck to back of wood. So didn't think about that. And then when it came time to put these bigger guys on, which caused even more problem with the thing, I just was like, you know, not gonna say that word on video. And then I just use the tape, and I guess that, I don't know, maybe it reduces the craft. Yeah, it does. It doesn't look as good if it wasn't there. But also, fun note, their little armies, I initially was going to use a thin wire to do it, and that resulted in their armies going and like running into each other. So that was annoying because then they would like get like stuck. And so then I just kind of resulted to this string, and it looks kind of rough and hand done, but I mean, hello, that's what this is. So tips for future sculpture students doing this project: I want to say don't stress, but that's just going to happen. If you have woodworking experience, good for you. If not, Russell, the woodshop guy, is going to be your very best friend. And he certainly became mine because I got a lot of help from him and also from my dad. And I would tell you the tools that I used, except I don't know the names. So various saw thingies and drill thingies, and I made little holes. And here's a fun fact. This, can you see it? This nail here. That's acting like a cotter pin. Yeah, that's fun to know. That my dad suggested. I have no idea what that means. Once again, so yeah, Russ is going to be your best friend. If you have experience, good for you. It's frustrating. It's hard. It's annoying. Sorry, being honest. I had a really hard time. This whole thing in here, so hard to figure out. And, like, everyone in the class made really big ones. And I just didn't really want to make one that was that big. And then, like, I don't know. I didn't want, like, a giant Mondo bed with, like, giant Mondo people. So just have patience. Get scrap wood if you can. But my best friend, besides Russell, was these round pieces that are pre-cut. You can find them at Michael's. You can find them at Hobby Lobby. I don't know about Home Depot. I didn't go to Home Depot. I don't like Home Depot. But they're like totally your best friend. And dowels. This is about a half an inch. And people in class tried to use one that was thinner than that. And like it didn't work for them. So I would suggest using half an inch. Because it's sturdy and it can support, you know, all this going on in here. These are just popsicle sticks, so, you know, it's not, like, terribly complicated, but it takes a lot of figuring out. I know people in class that did their figures first and their mechanism second. I wouldn't do it that way. I did mechanism first, figure second, because what's important is this and how this works, and my figures, like I said, give me problems, but you know, this is the important part. This turns this feeling. So, good luck, future sculpture students. I hope that maybe this little blurb helped you out. And this is my project. And despite whatever grade I got and whatever grade you get, you know, as long as you don't fail and, like, you like it, then just be happy. Because I like it. I mean, I think they're cute. They're just adorable.